We've got a major story out of Philadelphia. Let's start right there. John Heyman is reporting that the deal's in place for Dave Dombrowski to become the Phillies' new president of baseball operations. Dombrowski has been working with a group that wants to bring Major League Baseball to Nashville, recently denied any interest in the Philadelphia opening. Something apparently changed. Dombrowski won a World Series with the Red Sox in 2018 and the Florida Marlins in 1997. He's also been a GM of the Montreal Expos, 14 seasons with the Detroit Tigers. He's 64 years young. He's been around the sport for an awfully long time. Both you guys know him well. Arguably has better hair than all three of us.
prettier eyes.
Right. And that's saying something, because we're not no slouches. But seriously, if you're a fan of the Philadelphia Phillies, are you fired up right now? You got Dave Dombrowski.
Yes. Yes, and I'm coming from a position, he signed me to a multi-year deal with the Marlins, so we just showed on the bio there, 1997, we win a World Series. Dave Dombrowski, to me, absolutely old-school baseball guy. You go back to the days of the Chicago White Sox and then on to the Montreal Expos, Marlins, and the rest is history. Two World Championships now with the Red Sox getting the second one. So you're getting a lot of baseball knowledge, and I think there's a lot of comfort with that. I don't want to start here on the scenario in which of these old general managers are receptive to or can handle or want to bring in analytics. It's there. You got bright, intelligent people, and Dave Dombrowski is that. If I'm a Philly fan right now, absolutely.
What does it mean? Yeah. What does Dave Dombrowski mean? Like, that? Does that mean they're all in for the next 2 or 3 years? Is that what that means?
Well, I think...
Yes.
I think you look at what precedent has he shown in his last two jobs with the Tigers and with the Red Sox. He will always go the extra mile to make them competitive, always get the extra player to go and make that team its best each and every night. So I think that's where you're going to see. I mean, we've thought of the Phillies last year, we're going to make that run. They didn't make that run, and then we heard a lot of stuff the last, 10 days?
Yeah.
That they're going to pull back. I don't think there's any pullback in Dave Dombrowski. He's never been like that to me. Now, when he got rid of the team in Florida, I mean, that wasn't really him. It was the owner that was doing that.
Right.
But I think he's the kind of guy that will, I think, is, don't be surprised if he starts signing people or making huge decisions. This was an interesting move by the Phils.
And think about this. First of all, John Middleton, you talk about a gentleman owner who stays in the background, is involved, but isn't that involved where you see his name out front, with respect to letting.
He had a great quote this week about trading Zach Wheeler. He's like, I wouldn't trade him for Babe Ruth.
Right, right.
Which is a rare thing for him to do.
And right. He's not out there in front, but this guy, $160 million payroll, they're 10th in baseball. We know with the Harper signing, with McCutchen coming in, Nola's a front end guy, brings in Wheeler. Yes, there's an issue with the bullpen. I know Sir Anthony Dominguez ended up getting hurt, got through 100. Naris. So there's some issues within the roster, but trying. But here, think of this. When you always see the crotchety, tough manager, what's the next manager you bring in? A guy that's going to be more of a player's, people guy. Or you have somebody who's the people guy, you bring in a tough manager. Matt Klintak, while, nice young baseball executive, you go from the young, inexperienced guy, fair enough, right?
Yeah, absolutely.
To Dombrowski, who's been around forever. So I think that...
Which is a better match for Joe Girardi as manager.
And then Joe Girardi.
Yeah. So I like to look at these front office executives. To your point,
okay,
he can make a move right away. What kind of move would Dave Dombrowski make? Well, let's just go back to his first notable moves throughout his front office career. In 1988, when he was named the Expos GM, he made 6 trades in his first 2 months. Now, granted, that was with the Expos. In 91, new expansion team, the Marlins, he traded Trevor Hoffman in a deal for Gary Sheffield. He wanted a thunderous bat immediately, got one in 93. In 01, he's the Tigers president, Juan Encarnacion, the former outright fielder, Luis Pineda, for Dimitri Young, who was an integral part of those early Tigers teams. And then in 2015, he traded 4 prospects for Craig Kimbrell, and that was a huge element to a Red Sox team. While he scuffled a bit when they won the World Series and they kind of were using their starting pitchers in the World Series to get the final outs, he knew he needed that to win the marathon. So I guess what I'm asking is this. If Dave Dombrowski is taking this job right now, he was comfortable in the city of Nashville. He was excited about bringing either expansion or relocation, Major League Baseball to Nashville. He doesn't take this job At the age of 64, he's set. He likes living in Nashville. He doesn't take this job unless he's guaranteed. This is just me speculating. Yeah. Agree if you want. I'm going to go bring back JT Realmuto. I want to win a World Series. I'm not coming back here to do a rebuild with Joe Girardi as my manager and Bryce Harper, a $300 million guy. He only took this gig to spend more money and to go for it.
Yeah, apparently he wasn't that happy in Nashville. But I know what you're saying, right? But I think you're absolutely right. Now, the Realmuto thing is something that would take some time. What he can do immediately, what you showed with those moves, is that he can attack that bullpen. There's a glut of pitchers out there that are bullpen arms that he could get to immediately change that bullpen into a strength for Joe Girardi, who's one of the best at maneuvering that bullpen if he has the pieces. You look at the lineup. The lineup is still strong. It still has some pieces, though, that he can go and change. Realmuto, of course, being the big person. When you look at Dombrowski, he has such a history in the game. Let's not forget, I really feel when we sit in this booth and someone like La Russa gets hired, or Dombrowski gets hired, there's an ageism thing working here. There's a bias against anyone that's a certain age. Remember, Dombrowski was 31 years old when he took the GM job in Montreal. He knows both ends of it, being the swashbuckling 31-year-old guy in Montreal, speaking French and making trades.
Yeah.
But now he is, you know, that kind of guy, and to speak to your point, who's going to come in, and this is his last hurrah. He wants that third ring.
Right.
And he's going to try to do it with the Phillies.
That's what it feels like.
Yeah.
It feels that way.